Does universal transmission fluid exist? Well, I could try making one, but that's not how it works. When a transmission is developed, its fluid is developed alongside it. For transmission fluid, it's definitely or exchange. Have you hit subscribe? You haven't?
How are DCTF and CVTF different from ATF? And people often say that DCTs and CVTs break down more easily, so its oil needs to be changed frequently. So why is that?
Well, they're all talking about automatic transmissions here. Before the technology advanced, we only had manual transmissions. But as times changed, automatic transmissions started to appear. First came the automatic transmission, just the automission. Then we got the DCT, the dual clutch transmission. And after that came the CVT, the continuously variable transmission. That's how things evolved. Before DCT, there was something called the manual transmission. Basically, they added an automatic transmission on top of it. So the gears looked just like in a manual, but they shifted automatically. That's what we call an automated manual transmission, kind of a transition in between. And here's where the F comes in, right? ATF, DCTF, they all have an F at the end, right? F stands for fluid. In Korean, it is called ek. And let me explain the difference between oil and fluid. When the primary purpose is lubrication, we call it oil. But if it's more about circulation, cooling, rust prevention, or hydraulic pressure, even if it does have lubricating properties, we call it a fluid. So when we talk about automatic transmission fluid, or DCTF, we call it fluid because it focuses more on things other than just lubrication. But there is one exception. In a manual transmission, the gears actually rotate. It's more about lubrication than hydraulics or cooling. So it should really be called manual gear oil. But since everyone calls it transmission fluid, we call it MTF. Why are they named differently? It's because their operating principles are all different. What about an automatic transmission? How's it designed? It has a huge number of gear assemblies in the back. When power is transmitted, it's done using hydraulic force. At the front, there's a fan called a torque converter. As hydraulic fluid flows in and it spins the fan, this converted torque is then transmitted to the clutch. The clutch, through friction, engages the friction plates, transferring power to the planetary gears to change speeds. Since the gears are rotating, lubrication is obviously necessary. But to operate, the torque converter spins using hydraulic power, right? So the focus is more on hydraulic power. Usually about 7 to 8 liters of fluid go in. That's quite a lot. Imagine a factory stamping out products with a press. It uses hydraulic power to press them down. If the hydraulic fluid changes and its viscosity alters, then the exact force won't be transmitted, right? It's like that. If the viscosity of hydraulic fluid changes, the force changes. If automatic transmission fluid undergoes thermal oxidation and its viscosity changes, the torque transmitted will also change. That shouldn't happen. It needs to be designed to prevent thermal oxidation. And since the gears are rotating, it also needs lubrication, of course. That means it involves friction plates. So friction plates must be included. A friction modifier needs to be added there. All these elements must be present. Moving on to DCTF. In a dual clutch transmission, there are two clutches. But instead of pressing it with your foot, the clutch is engaged by electric control. So there are two clutches like this. There are two drive shafts. At this point, the gears engage with each other. They adjust to change the speed. This isn't about hydraulic power. As I mentioned, it's a combination of gears. Instead of calling it fluid, it should really be called oil, but conventionally, it's referred to as transmission fluid, or smaller in scale. DCTF uses less fluid. Only about 2 to 3 liters go in. I said that making it operate in a small space is a harsh condition. Since the gears are also meshing and rotating, and friction plates need to engage and adjust, a lot of thermal oxidation occurs due to friction heat. The lubricant volume is small, yet a lot of thermal oxidation occurs here. That makes it truly harsh conditions. The lifespan shortens. So these also need to be made with very good synthetic oils. And since the mechanism is small, it needs to be formulated with low viscosity. People might say, just reduce the friction. But if the clutch doesn't have the right amount of friction, it could slip. It needs to engage and rotate precisely. What if the gears don't turn? So friction characteristics are crucial. DCTs have both wet and dry clutches. When the clutch is immersed in lubricant, that's what we call a wet clutch. A dry clutch is located externally. The lubricant only goes into the gear, right? When we talk about DCTs, we're typically referring to wet clutches. This is how I hope you can understand it. Next, CVT, continuously variable transmission. It's a transmission that provides continuous changes. It's like those two triangular cone shapes you see at amusement parks, which are called Diablos. CVTs also have two cone-like shapes attached. These are called pulleys, and there are either two of them or a single cone shape like this. Then a chain belt is wrapped around them. So how is the speed adjusted? The chain moves, expanding wide and then narrowing, changing like that. When it moves back and forth, it's made to move via friction plates. The chain belt moves back and forth, and it absolutely must not break. Problems like corrosion can occur. So oxidation stability needs to be very good. Bubbles must absolutely not form inside. It moves back and forth due to friction between the chain belt and the pulleys. Therefore, the friction characteristics for this are very important. It's a bit different from friction with friction plate. Developing CVTF is also not easy. Haven't you subscribed yet? Do it right now. Click that button, frequently breakdown, which meant frequent oil changes, right? DCTF units are smaller, and I mentioned they only take about 2 to 3 liters. They undergo thermal oxidation very quickly. The CVT units are also smaller in scale than automatic transmissions. I believe they take about 5 liters. Also, due to its structure, CVTs generate a lot of friction heat. If debris or contaminants from corroded friction plates or other parts get in, it won't move smoothly. Once the movement isn't smooth, thermal oxidation accelerates rapidly. When aiming for low viscosity to move such a complex structure, thermal oxidation happens quickly. Therefore, their lifespan is even shorter than ATF, and they break down faster. For ATF, DCTF, and CVTF, viscosity stability is crucial for all of them. What's related to viscosity is thermal oxidation stability. When thermal oxidation occurs, sludge forms and the viscosity changes, right? So these two go hand in hand. All three types must be low viscosity, because in the past, larger cars used to have bigger automatic transmissions. That wasn't a problem then, but cars keep getting smaller, right? So the transmissions will also get smaller, and all the gears inside will get smaller too, right? Then the internal space, the design, becomes very tight. This all needs to circulate for lubrication, and if the lubricant is too thick, it won't circulate. That's why everything needs to go towards low viscosity. It's a low viscosity trend anyway. So some people ask, is there a universal oil? Well, maybe it could be developed, but it's not like that. Because each car manufacturer chooses different transmissions, right? They develop the oil along with the transmission. The companies that make transmissions hold the specifications. There are no international standards. Each operates on a different principle, and you must buy and use the oil that matches it. Otherwise, it will break down. Most of these come as lifetime or no change oils. What lifetime or no change means is this. People usually replace their cars after driving about 100,000 to 150,000 kilometers, right? They're basically telling you to replace it around that time, but it's definitely true that transmission fluid must be changed. Oils cannot be used for a lifetime. I hope that answered your question. For accurate information on lubricants, stay within Bulgin. This was Dr. Kim Bohoon, your lube expert. Please like and subscribe and turn on notifications. See you next time, everyone, okay?
Come out! Come out! Come out!